हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज तरन्नुम सैयद फ्रॉम केबीपी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सातारा, प्रेजेंटिंग ऑन एनवायरनमेंट सस्टेनेबल कंप्यूटिंग एंड आईओटी एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी फॉर इंटरनेशनल एफटीपी ऑन एनवायरनमेंट एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी। दीज आर द ब्रीफ डिटेल्स ऑफ माय वीक वन एंड वीक टू वीडियो। इन वीक वन आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एनवायरनमेंट सस्टेनेबल कंप्यूटिंग रिलेटेड टू द टेक्नो थ्रैश दैट इज गेटिंग जनरेटेड थ्रू यूसेज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस and how we can take steps to make it environment sustainable with the help of green computing. In second week, I talked about Internet of Things and sustainability, in which a case study of waste management system was discussed and what efforts can be taken to make IoT applications sustainable. The outcomes of this video shall be that the students will be able to analyze the role of environment sustainability. They can apply critical thinking skills to provide sustainable solutions for every application. Also, they can estimate the carbon footprint calculation values for any product. Here is a table representing ISO standards for green computing to use electronic devices in IoT application. ISO 14001 was developed in 2015 and it was used to improve environmental performance with this family of standards. ISO 14004 was developed in 2016 and it gave a general guidelines on implementation of green computing. The third standard, that is ISO 14005, was developed in 2019 and it gave guideline for flexible approach to phased implementation. Here are few IoT guidelines for sustainability which are referred. These gets broadly classified into three categories. First one, collaboration models and incentive alignment. Second one, business and investment models. And third one is impact measurement. We should concentrate on impact measurement aspect as far as environment sustainability is concerned. So we will read out just three guidelines related to impact measurement. Embrace a sustainability awareness culture to respond to new generation demand, enhancing the brand reputation and attracting top talent. Next is adopting a framework based on the UN Sustainable Development Goals to evaluate potential impact and measure results. And the third guideline related to impact measurement is we should identify a potential sustainable development goal and target addressable by our IoT project and incorporate it into the commercial design. So here we can see that as far as environment and sustainability is concerned, the impact measurement related guidelines are very important while designing or developing any product or application. Now, why IoT is chosen as a topic for this video? The reason behind is you can see through the graph representing that what will be the device adoption or IoT device adoption rate by 2025. It may drastically increase from 15.41%, which was there in 2015, up to 75.44% of the market in 2025. That's why IoT is very recent and most important activities in the research area which has been carrying out these days. This is a slide representing different devices that are used in IoT. Basically, sensors, devices with wireless data technologies, for example, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, radio frequency, etc. And the data center devices, or you can say cloud data storage and management devices, which may include servers, clients, storage devices, and network devices. So from this, we can identify that lot many electronic devices are involved in an IoT application. Now here is a diagram representing the flow of any IoT application. Now from the diagram itself, we can see that as each phase of IoT application involves some or the other electronic device, so to identify the environment sustainability or power consumption of devices of an entire IoT application shall take a lot of time. Almost a thesis can be written on the power consumption of IoT devices at each phase. So we are going to consider The last part, that is analytics or data storage part, or the data center where the devices like computers can be used. And in this regard, we are going to consider a device known as thin client, which can act as an environment sustainable device as compared to our normal personal computers or desktop computers. Now, as we all know that IoT applications are M2M, that is machine to machine communication applications. Here in an industrial IoT application, machine to machine HMI thin clients are used, which are nothing but integrated touchscreen computers which act as clients and which depend on some other computer which is known as its server to fulfill its traditional computational roles. That means using a thin client doesn't perform actual computation on itself. All the computation is performed on the servers, but user gets a feel that all the computations are getting performed on the client machine itself. In the diagram, you can see the power consumption comparison of desktop PCs, laptop PCs and different types of thin clients, and it is observed that thin clients consume much less power as compared to the desktop PC. Here we can see that a conventional workstation PC for a medium level user has a GWP of 417 kilograms of CO2 emissions, whereas for a thin client, including its share of central server usage and cooling, the GWP ranges from 156 to 277 kg of CO2 emissions, which comparatively is very less as compared to normal PCs. In the energy saving mode, they only use about 1 watts of power. Because of centralized management of servers, it also offers a potential for automation, which is another significant issue in environment saving. And during the periods of low demand, they are automatically switched off, which obviously reduces the power consumption in a sleep mode or in a no demand mode. Here is a table showing comparison of PC and thin computing energy consumption, electricity cost and CO2 emissions. In the leftmost column are represented different models of PCs and thin clients. In the second column is shown the average power consumption in watts per unit in all the 4 stages of a computer, that is whether it is active, idle, in the sleep mode or whether it is switched off. Based on it, the annual power consumption is calculated, and in the last column we can see the operational phase over 5 years of PCs and thin clients, which show consumption, electricity cost and CO2 emissions. If we analyze the last most column of CO2 emissions, we can see that the values that are shown for the thin clients are much more less as compared to the normal PCs. So the table clears the power consumption or CO2 emission aspect of thin client as compared to the normal desktop PC. Now we are going to talk about how carbon footprints are actually calculated. As per IBM TriRiga version 10.5.1, the carbon footprint calculator function is based on 3 environmental scopes, which include the following components: on-site energy production and other industrial activities, area of facilities and the percentage of occupancy, facility energy use such as electricity, gas, coal, oil, also solar energy, corporate travel such as plane, rail and vehicles, and also the corporate waste. So considering all the components, the carbon footprint calculator converts each of these energy, travel and waste sources from their original unit of measure, for example kilowatts per hour or miles, to tons of CO2 per year by applying emission conversion factors. The calculator then uses the most current energy, travel and waste data from the energy log, travel log and a waste log. These logs are saved until you delete them. That means carbon footprint calculator basically involves an emission conversion function to convert the original unit of measure into CO2 emissions. The carbon calculator function uses a circular process which is having following steps. It triggers the carbon footprint calculation process, retrieves the locations and organizations with the changes, retrieve all the inputs, perform the calculations, create a carbon log with all of the input and output data, update the current period carbon footprint, and then reset the carbon calculation needed flag so that again the process gets repeated in a circular fashion. Here are the formulas for calculating greenhouse gases that are emitted. These are the carbon footprint calculations for energy that are used for scope 1, scope 2. Now what is scope 1? Scope 1 is the direct energy emissions and scope 2 are the indirect energy emissions, and carbon footprints can be calculated for all the scopes. Here are the carbon footprint calculations for travel component in any application. Again, for scope 1, for scope 2, and also scope 3, that is nothing but travel emissions for vehicles that are owned by the company. Next is the carbon footprint calculation formula for other emissions, that means maybe through the corporate waste. So all these formulas for energy, travel and waste give us a total estimation of CO2 emissions that can take place in a particular application. As far as sustainability of the component which we have chosen for today's discussion is considered, that is thin client, the following table represent comparison of PC and thin computing material consumption in the account of their lifespan and reliability benefits. We can see two scenarios represented for 100 seats and for 5000 seats. We can see that average weight per unit in pounds for a PC is 24 pounds and for a thin client is just 6 pounds. The replacement schedule for PC is after every 3 years, whereas for a thin client it is after every 5 years. And when we talk about replacement strategy for any electronic device, it relates directly to the techno thrash that is getting generated due to the replacement policies. So as replacement year of thin client is greater than normal PC, the generation of techno thrash rate will be also smaller as compared to general PC. Then the total weight over 20 years is calculated for 100 seats and 5000 seats. Normalized weight is calculated. And finally, the weight reduction per year in pounds comes out to be 680 for 100 seats and 34,000 for 5000 seats. So the percentage of weight reduction by the usage of thin client as compared to PC is 82%, which is a bigger value which can be considered positively for utilizing thin client and replacing PCs with thin clients. Yes, now relating our discussion with the waste management application which we discussed in the first video is developing an IoT application with the use of thin client as a sustainable computing device will give us a reduction in collection cost, no missed pickups, reducing the overflows of trash bins, because if the trash bins are overflown, lot many hazardous gases are released from the wastage. We can have a waste generation analysis, that means we can classify the wastage into different types of waste products like e-waste, metal waste and organic waste, and if this waste is classified, we can have different disposal techniques based on their classification. If all these aspects are considered while developing an IoT applications, it will definitely cause a CO2 emission reduction in the environment, which will improve our sustainability for the future generations. So friends, the summary or the conclusion which will come after entire discussion in this video is we should adopt green computing, which is nothing but green design, green manufacturing, green use, green recycling and disposal techniques, that is nothing but considering the CO2 emissions from an electronic device at each level, right from its design up to its disposal. So friends, a quote for you: computing nowadays is not just about the computers anymore, it is about the living of human beings in the sustainable environment. Thank you. Thank you.